Good morning. Today we are going to solve free response question number 3 from the 2015 AP Physics 1 exam.
Flippin' physics.
We have a block initially located at position 0, the equilibrium position for the spring. We use the block to compress the spring a distance capital D and then release the block. The block slides along the level, frictionless surface until it returns back to that equilibrium position, at which point it encounters a rough part of the track, in other words, a part of the track which does have friction.
See, Bo, I'm not the only one who makes up problems with both frictionless and frictionful surfaces.
Frictionful? Is that a word?
The block continues to slide along the rough surface until it eventually comes to a stop, a distance 3 capital D from the equilibrium position. Bobby, could you please read part A, I, and double I?
Sure. Part A, on the axis below, sketch and label graphs of the following two quantities as a function of the position of the block between x equals negative D and x equals positive 3D. You do not need to calculate values for the vertical axis, but the same vertical scale should be used for both quantities. Part AI, the kinetic energy K of the block. Part A double I, the potential energy U of the block spring system.
For the record, because K stands for spring constant, I severely dislike using K for kinetic energy. I will be using capital KE instead for kinetic energy. Also, because the block is displaced to the left, for displacement, or delta x, I would much prefer to use negative capital D. I know in the end, because x in 1/2 kx² for elastic potential energy is squared, that the answer ends up being the same. However, people so often forget direction. It's just important.
Did anybody else notice the soapbox,
Mr. Stop.
Leave it.
Bo, please tell me about the elastic potential energy stored in the spring and the kinetic energy of the block when the spring is fully compressed at the very beginning.
When the block is at x equals negative d, it is at rest. So its velocity is 0, therefore its kinetic energy equals 0. The compression of the spring is at its maximum magnitude, d. Therefore, the elastic potential energy is at its maximum value.
The equation for elastic potential energy is 1/2 times the spring constant times the displacement from the equilibrium position squared. Therefore, the value of the initial and maximum elastic potential energy is 1/2 times the spring constant times capital D squared. Bobby, what happens to the energies as the block moves from negative capital D to the equilibrium position?
Because the elastic potential energy is proportional to x squared, it will decrease as an x squared function. And because the surface is frictionless and there is no force applied, mechanical energy is conserved. Therefore, elastic potential energy will be completely converted to kinetic energy as the block goes from x equals negative d to x equals 0. So kinetic energy will increase as an x squared function. When the block gets to 0 or the equilibrium position, x equals 0, so the elastic potential energy will be 0, and all of the elastic potential energy will have been converted to kinetic energy. In other words, the kinetic energy will be at its maximum value at equilibrium position and will have the same value as the elastic potential energy did when the block was at negative D.
Make sure you include a legend to identify which line goes with which type of energy. And remember, your graph is a part of your answer, your solution to the problem on the AP test. So please be very careful when drawing the lines on your graphs. Billy, what happens to the energies of the block as it moves from the equilibrium position to 3 capital D?
Now there is friction, so mechanical energy is no longer conserved. However, there is no force applied, so we can use the work due to friction equals the change in mechanical energy equation. We can expand that out to force of kinetic friction times displacement times cosine theta, which equals mechanical energy final minus mechanical energy initial. Set the zero line at the center of mass of the block, the initial point at negative capital D, and the final point at positive 3 capital D. There is zero final mechanical energy because the block stops, and the initial mechanical energy is only the elastic potential energy we solved for before, which is 1/2 the spring constant times capital D squared. The force of kinetic friction will do work on the block and convert the kinetic energy to heat and sound, and because the block stops at x equals positive 3 capital D, the kinetic energy will be zero there. Because the force of kinetic friction is constant, the work due to friction will cause a linear decrease in the kinetic energy as little d in the work due to friction equation increases from 0 to 3 capital D.
Correct! And please, when you draw a straight line on a graph on the AP test, use a straight edge. But we're missing something. Just because something is zero doesn't mean we don't have to draw it on the graph.
Oh, the elastic potential energy from 0 to positive 3D is 0 because the spring is no longer compressed. We should add that to the graph.
Yes, it is common to forget to add something which has a constant value of 0 to the graph. However, it still needs to be on the graph. All right, the situation now changes. Bobby, could you please read this part?
The spring is now compressed twice as much to delta x equals 2D. A student is asked to predict whether the final position of the block will be twice as far at x equals 6D. The student reasons that since the spring will be compressed twice as much as before, the block will have more energy when it leaves the spring, so it will slide farther along the track before stopping at position x equals 6D. Part BI. Which aspects of the student's reasoning, if any, are correct? Explain how you arrived at your answer.
Bo, could you please answer this part?
Okay. I'm just explaining which parts of the student's reasoning are correct, right?
Yes, Bo, just the correct parts.
Okay. We should write, the student is correct that because the spring is compressed more than before, it will have more energy when it leaves the spring, so it will slide farther. That's it.
That's it. Bobby, part B double I is, which aspects of the student's reasoning, if any, are incorrect? Please explain how you arrived at your answer. There's no please in it, though.
Well, I know that double the compression won't mean the block stops at double the distance because...
Bobby, could you phrase your answer as if you are writing it on the exam, please?
Okay. The student is incorrect that double the compression will result in double the distance. The elastic potential energy stored in the spring follows 1/2 the spring constant times the displacement from equilibrium position squared, which is not a linear relationship for x.
Very nice, Bobby. Now could you please read part C?
Part C. Use quantitative reasoning, including equations as needed, to develop an expression for the new final position of the block. Express your answer in terms of capital D.
Billy? Go ahead, please.
Well, I already worked partway through this problem. Let's pick it up at the expanded work due to friction equals change in mechanical energy equation. Let's call displacement 1 the event with the original displacement of negative capital D. The angle in the work due to friction equation is 180 degrees because the displacement of the block is to the right and the force of friction is to the left. We can rearrange that to get displacement 1 equals the spring constant times capital D squared divided by the quantity 2 times the force of kinetic friction. Let's call displacement 2 the event with the displacement of negative 2 times capital D. Plugging that into the equation gives us an elastic potential energy of 1/2 the spring constant times 4 capital D squared. The force of kinetic friction and angle remain the same, and we can solve for displacement 2. Displacement 2 equals 4 times the spring constant times capital D squared divided by the quantity 2 times the force of kinetic friction, which means displacement 2 equals 4 times displacement 1, So the block will slide four times as far as before. So displacement 2 equals 4 times displacement 1, or 4 times 3 capital D, or 12 capital D.
Very nice, Billy. Bobby, could you now please read part D?
Part D. Explain how any correct aspects of the student's reasoning identified in part B are expressed by your mathematical relationships in part C. Explain how your relationships in part C correct any incorrect aspects of the student's reasoning identified in part B. Refer to the relationships you wrote in part C, not just the final answer you obtained by manipulating those relationships.
Bo, please answer the question.
I'm
not really sure what that question is asking.
Yeah, it's kind of an awkwardly worded question and does seem a bit redundant with the other questions. I think what they're asking you to do here is to use the mathematical reasoning from part C to explain your answers from part B.
Okay, well, the student is correct that the block will have more energy when compressed farther.
The original elastic potential energy is only one half the spring constant times d squared, while the new elastic potential energy is 2 times the spring constant times d squared. Therefore, the new elastic potential energy is greater than the original elastic potential energy.
I like that, Bo. Bobby, what else?
The student is also correct that the block will slide farther along the track before stopping, because the force of kinetic friction remains the same, and the work done by friction to stop the block will be increased because the amount of initial potential energy is increased. Therefore, because the work due to friction equals the force of kinetic friction times displacement times the cosine theta, which equals 0 minus the initial mechanical energy, the displacement D must increase because the initial mechanical energy increased.
Bobby, that's good. Billy, what is the student incorrect about?
The student is incorrect that the stopping distance will be linearly increased because the energy is not linearly increased. The energy is increased as the square of the distance because the elastic potential energy equals 1/2 times the spring constant times the displacement from equilibrium position squared.
That is it. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.